Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard.
Welcome back. It is 844, 74 degrees. As you can see, interior designer Leslie Ezelle is ready for Halloween.
Yes.
She's ready for fall. Thank you so much for being
here. Thanks for having me.
I remember watching on HGTV Design Star, and you're sharing some of your easy do-it-yourself ideas for Halloween.
Yes, stuff fun to do with kids.
You don't have to pay a ton to make it look festive.
Right, and be creative. And with kids, you know, I'm always trying to find fun projects that I can do with my kids. I have six of them, so.
Wait a minute, you have six of them, and you have twins right now.
Twins, yes, brand new twins. They're 11 weeks.
Oh
yeah, just for the record, I outsourced that. It was a surrogate. Used a surrogate, so I bounced back pretty good.
Wow.
But you're busy.
And so you want to do stuff to get the kids involved. And
exactly.
When I walked in, I thought this was something you probably purchased at the store, but then I looked a little closer.
Yeah, it's actually plumbing rings. Okay,
look,
so I get most of my ideas from like the hardware store. I spend a lot of time in the hardware store.
Yeah.
So these are just plumbing rings, and I thought, you know what, maybe you could put all these together. I've attached one with a rubber band, took a white rubber band, tied it in two. Made all of them attach, and then also you can use wire. And then these are just the tops of the dried out corn that you find at Tom Thumb
that
I sprayed.
You spray painted.
Cool thing about this is each year you can just kind of close it up and then store it away, because I have a problem with storage in my house.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but it's always an issue. And so this is an easy thing that you can put out each year.
That's a great looking idea.
And
we're kind of keeping
using
the metal.
Using
metal. Yeah. The metal thing is pretty hot right now.
Yes, I'm very much into the industrial look, so I feel like it's a really cool look. You can put it in your entryway. It's a nice little look.
This is easy
this
and
is
cheap.
Cool.
I like this.
Very easy and cheap. This I have going up. I have 15 of these suckers going up my stairs on the side of the stairs, the way up. And then these are actually pumpkins that look like acorns. And I put these like in big bowls, on
the
coffee table.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. So just spray paint. A little bit
of spray paint
will go a long way.
Exactly. That's super, super easy. This one right here, this is a chalkboard pumpkin.
You paint
it with chalkboard paint. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Again, craft store, get most of my ideas from that.
The kids have fun with this, I bet.
Yes.
Huh?
And then the cool thing is using these little markers as opposed to regular chalk, it makes for a nice clean finish on your lettering.
Oh, like a paint pen, right?
It's a paint pen, but it's made for chalkboards.
Oh.
And then if you mess up, you go back with the black and kind of touch it up.
Nice.
So, yeah. And then spray a nice shellac on it, and then it'll be waterproof. You can put
it
in front of your house.
Kids could do designs.
They can put their names on it.
They
can
do.
Go to town,
That's
graffiti,
fine.
Whatever the heck they want to do.
Okay.
And then this is another little metallic pumpkin that I put on top of the tips of wheat. You can find this. This is like a little display thing. You find it at your grocery store. Tear them off, glue them to a little plastic Tupperware top, and then you have a nice display for a little pumpkin. And then last, this is corn on the cob.
This is my favorite.
Yeah, this is corn on the cob.
Surprised.
Me and my son were actually doing this last night. The dried corn on the cob, you just break it in two, you glue it together again to a Tupperware top, put it on a nice plate, and then it serves as a candle holder.
That
it makes for a
great.
Nice table setting. It's a little different, and you don't have to spend a fortune doing it.
Oh, I heard we have a picture of your little ones right here.
Yeah.
Let's take
good.
A look.
Yes,
oh,
they're my little babies. They
are
just so sweet.
What are their names?
It is a beating, let me tell you. It is a beating at 47 to have twins. I don't know what the heck I was thinking, but I'm in it now.
And what are their names?
It's Isabel and Liam.
Oh,
Isabel and Liam,
sweet.
And that's
so
my partner, yeah.
Well, thanks for sharing all of these ideas.
I appreciate you having me. Thank you so much.
You can find a link, by the way, to Leslie's website on our website, myfoxtfw.com. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Appreciate you.